guys, the Bench Buddies are back with our week 6 NFL preview and picks. As always, I got Ethan joining me. And this week, we don't have a guest, unfortunately. Hopefully, we can have one next week for you guys. But before we get into it, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. Get us 200 subscribers to be entered into that autograph item giveaway. And we'll jump into last week's picks here. Ethan, I came out on top here, but which one of these games is probably the most surprising to you?
Well, that's a good question. I would say that Detroit-New England pick, we swept Detroit on that one, and New England obviously ended up winning, so I think that's the most surprising that we all picked Detroit, and they did not win. Other than that, you know, those late game slates is really where you got me, where you got gained some ground.
Yeah, and we got, you know, Jack finished 7-9, and, you know, that's tied with Micah for last place this year, but, you know, that's not the worst overall record. Still got to shout out AJ to that one. But, you know, Cam is staying afloat with kind of the two best weeks pretty much in our history of doing this with 11-4 and 11-3. Someone hopefully can dethrone him next week. But before getting into the teams this week, we got the teams on the bye. And which one of these teams right now is kind of the most surprising team where they're at?
I'd say surprising in a bad way would be the Las Vegas Raiders. We were all expecting this AFC West to be that big division where they had the Raiders, Broncos, Chargers, and Chiefs, which is the most stacked division, but these teams, they got to lose against each other. So that's why I think it's a kind of a bad start for the Raiders, but they do have a lot of time after this bye to have a nice scheduling break. And I hope they can turn the season around.
Yeah. For me, I got to go with the Lions. Obviously, you know, they have kind of been through it. High scoring offense, and then you go put up a dud before the week of your bye, and they're, you know, 1-4. Texans are 1-3-1, and then the Titans are the only team that has a winning record here at 3-2. You know, these teams have kind of adjusted, kind of thought where most of them would be, I'd say, at the beginning of this part. So now they're looking to just have strong halves out of the bye. But we'll talk about last night's game. We got the Commanders obviously coming out on top because of the goal line stand with a minute to go. Stopped them. Mooney was short of the goal line, and that's how they won this game essentially. But another ugly showing on Thursday night football for both teams, and I just can't wait till next Thursday. Hopefully going to be a better game with the Saints playing, and I think it's maybe the Cardinals, I believe, I'm not sure, but
should be slightly better.
But should be anything better than this would be great. But we'll talk about our Sunday games here, what you guys are here for. We got my Packers going against the Jets, so got to roll with the Packers in a bounce back week. I think this is potentially a week where we can see Rodgers air it out. You know, they got Sauce, but who's Sauce going to be on? Because at this point, all the Packers wide receiver ones are kind of the identical. More than likely, he could be on Lazard, which could mean a big day for Romeo Dobbs or another big day for Randall Cobb. And this ground game will look to establish themselves early against the Jets front that, you know, has been pretty solid this year. But I think the Packers do have the edge in the trenches. And that's kind of where I see this game getting won, with the Packers win, probably a two-possession game.
Yeah, I'm going to take the Jets in this one. I think if the Jets win, it's going to need to be a shootout type of thing, because I am with you there. I think Rodgers is going to air it out this week. I think 7.5 points is quite big for this, but then again, it's Green Bay at home coming off that London game where they kind of got their hearts broke a little bit, and the Jets have come off winning two straight. So Jets are playing really good football, and so I'm going to take them, but don't be surprised, obviously, if the Packers win.
And then we got the Niners going on the road to the Falcons. Big story here is, you know, the Niners, I guess, health, because we know Elijah Mitchell is still out and Jeff Wilson Jr. has a few more weeks until the bye. And Kittle, you know, how's he doing still? I mean, you know, he's been healthy the last two games, but it seems like he always has an injury designation. And, you know, Garoppolo, obviously, he's been pretty solid, but not to a point where it's like, they're glad that they kept him, because I think he, you know, is just doing enough to win games, managing games, nothing spectacular. But you got to go with the Niners here. I think their defense is way better than the Falcons, and that's where this game's going to be won.
Yep, I'm with you there. I think the Falcons have some problems they need to solve there on the defensive side of the ball and the offensive side of the ball. So the Niners overall roster, they're playing better football. Jimmy G is finally back, and hopefully Kittle will play. If Kittle will play, I think it's going to be a pretty easy game. Debo's going to have a big game in this one as well. So I'm going to take the Niners.
And then we got our first disagreement of the, well, second disagreement, but first real disagreement here. We got the Patriots, Browns, pretty favorite you know, pretty close game here. Over under 43, Cleveland's favored by 2.5, but I got to go with New England. I think Bailey Zapp can really get it going here. I'm pretty sure he's passed Hoyer on the depth chart, no matter when Hoyer comes back for number two. And, you know, Mac Jones, is it possible that he can come back this week? Yeah, that's possible as well. But I think they're going to play it conservative, kind of let him go maybe one more week. And then I think Mac Jones comes back. But I think Zapp has a pretty good last showing for the year. And, you know, with Damien Harris out, Rohan Stevenson, he's going to have a big game, probably 25, 30 touches out of the backfield. So if you've had him in fantasy, you should probably start him just because this is going to be a ground game.
Yeah, and I think nobody can run the ball as efficient as the Cleveland Browns. So I think they're going to dominate that time of possession. Chubb's going to have a big game. Kareem Hunt's going to have a big game. And the Browns, I think they're going to win it this week at home.
And then we got the Jaguars looking to rebound for some tough losses. And you got the Colts, who are, you know, kind of already keeping their AFC South playoff, you know, division hopes alive. But I got to go with the Jaguars here. I like Jaguars on the road. They had a bad showing last week. And I think, you know, what team is better to do it than against the Colts? Because they've really struggled this year in a lot of games. And, you know, obviously they won that 12-9 game last Thursday against the Broncos. So they've had extra time off to really think about that and kind of get some things right. But their big storyline is Jonathan Taylor. Will he play? It's trending upward like he will play. And that could really mean the difference in this game moving forward.
Yeah, I think this is the game where we'll see if the Jaguars are like how far they are from that rebuild, because they had a good start and now they're already back down to 2-3 behind the Colts in the division. So if they beat them here, 3-3 looks a lot better. If they end up losing though, it's going to be a tough season. So I'm taking the Jaguars either way though.
And then here we got a big matchup, a battle of Kirk Cousins and Skylar Thompson. And unfortunately, you know, maybe Tua is playing this game and maybe he doesn't get hurt this whole year. They could be 5-0, but here they are sitting at 3-2. You know, the big ping pong table, what we've heard from Miami is, you know, the captain stepped up, removed that. So they have a chip on their shoulder already 5 games in. But I don't think it's going to matter this week because the Vikings are the more complete team, at least playing like it right now. With Cook healthy, his first good game last week, Justin Jefferson went off. And, you know, you have Thielen to stop, Irv Smith to stop, even KJ Osborne to stop. It's a tough team on offense, and I just don't think the defense is capable of it right now. And then when they flip it over on the other side of the ball, the Vikings defense has been playing a lot better than a lot of people think. And that's where I think this game's going to be won, with a few Vikings turnovers.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a pretty close game. Although I'm going to take the Vikings. I'm not sure what their record is, but they seem to always win these close games this year. I know they lost them all last year, but a 4-1 start, really didn't outplay anybody since week one against the Packers. Yeah, I just can't take the third string quarterback from the Dolphins to win them this game. It's a big game. I see it being close, but the Vikings should win it.
Then we have another good game, a battle of surprisingly 2-3 teams. Bengals looking to get back on track after their heartbreaking loss last week to the Ravens. And I think that's what they're going to do. Go into New Orleans, beat Andy Dalton. You know, the Saints team had a lot of expectations coming into the year with Olave coming in, Michael Thomas healthy, Kamara fully healthy. And here they are. All three of those guys are already hurt and Jameis is hurt. And, you know, this just seems like this is the team this year that's going to have the injury bug for this team. And that's why I just got to stay away from that. And I think the Bengals have a better defense for this game. And for matchup-wise, I think the Bengals win.
Yeah, I just really like the Saints at home. Automatically, it makes them, like, almost favorites in this game. I think the Bengals are going to slip up here and lose a game that's about 15-hour drive from their house. So take the Saints. So it's going to be a tough game for both of them. I think it's going to be physical. I mean, the Bengals, like, they should win this game, but I think it's one of those trap games. I'm going to take the home team here.
And then we got the Ravens going on the road to the 4-1 Giants, and I got to go with the Ravens here. I think this is a game where Lamar absolutely goes off. And you saw the tape last week against the Packers. The Giants, you know, did enough, came from behind, shut them out in the second half. But I don't think that's the case this week with Lamar and the dynamic offense. I think they're going to keep scoring. I think, you know, Baltimore can probably put up almost 30, and I think the Giants will put up at least 2 touchdowns. So I like the over for sure in this one. But the spread, I don't know about that one. It could be 5-point or it could be 15-point win. So I would stay away from that, but I just go money line straight up with the Ravens.
I'm with you there. I mean, who would have thought we're saying the Giants are 4-1 here going into week 6, which is crazy to think about. I mean, I think I had them going 2-15. Good thing we didn't predict, like, publish those predictions for the season. But hey, I'm going to take the Ravens in this one. I just think they're a better team. And it doesn't matter on the road. I'm with you there. Going to be the over. Lamar's going to be running all over the place.
And then we got your Steelers at home against the Bucks. I got to go with the Bucks here just because they don't have JJ or TJ Watt on Steelers. And Minka Fitzpatrick, you know, got kind of exposed last week. And Kenny Pickett, though, is the only bright spot. He's been pretty solid, I would say, in his first career start last week. But he doesn't really have any help. Boswell even had a bad week, missing 2 field goals. So I do think the Steelers will rebound a little bit, score more than 3 points. But I do like Tampa to come out on top.
Yeah, I'm going to take the Steelers in here. Totally unbiased pick at home. I just think the Steelers need a spark, and they got a spark from Kenny Pickett. And I think this is the week that they at least play better. I don't think they can go 1-5 and get blown out again. So I think they're going to play better. They have a shot to win it. It's at home. I just think this is one of those games where you don't expect it to happen, and I just think they're going to win the game. Buccaneers are probably solid, but Steelers, go Steelers.
And then moving over to the 4 o'clock games, we got the Rams hosting the Panthers. And, you know, it's going to be a new look Panthers after Matt Rhule got fired. But Baker might not even play in this game, so it could be PJ Walker time. And that's all you need to know for this one. So you got to go with the Rams.
Yep. Got the Rams in this one for sure.
And then you got Cardinals, Seahawks, and I'm going with the upset pick here, Seahawks at home. Team can score points, and Geno has really started to come out and look like, you know, kind of a diamond in a rough finally after his, you know, whirlwind of a career. And it looks like he found his home here. They're letting him air it out. He has good weapons on the outside. And, you know, Kenneth Walker obviously has to start now for the rest of the year with Rashad Penny out for the year with a broken leg. And I think it's his time to shine. I thought Kenneth Walker would be, you know, a dark horse rookie of the year candidate. And now it's his time to shine and kind of prove that to me. You know, it's only week 6 here, so he could, you know, have some really good games and be in that consideration. I think this one's going to come in the air where this, you know, Cardinals have a good front. And if they want to win this game, they're going to have to air it out.
Yeah, I think Arizona will win it. I do think Kenneth Walker's going to have a big game, though. I mean, I was an owner in him in all my fantasy leagues, so it's time to start him. It's time to hit him and put him in that run at RB2. And I think he's going to have a big game. Seattle always runs the ball effectively, and I think putting Kenneth Walker back there is going to make it even more explosive. But I'm taking the Cardinals anyway, though.
And then probably the best game of the week. You got Bills going on the road to Kansas City. And I can't bet against the Chiefs here at home against the Bills just because I think history repeats itself. You know, we saw the Bills, what, they won last year, right, in Kansas City. But the playoffs, you know, it comes down to it. That's when it only matters. And it seems like the Chiefs always have their edge. So I think they're going to keep their hot streak going, you know, with the close win last week against Raiders. I think they come out this week, guns a-blazing, put up a 30-piece, and hang it to the Bills, you know, who are obviously looking like a great offense as well. But I will go the Chiefs money line for sure if I'm trying to win some money.
Yeah, I think this is going to be a really close game. Obviously, it's AFC Championships, you know, basically other game. But I'm taking the Chiefs in this one. I just think it's going to be a really good game. It's going to be game of the week. This is the one you're going to want to watch at 425. But offensive, I don't know if there's going to be a punt in this game. Who knows? I mean, it's possibly that there's no punting in this game. I'm just going to take the Chiefs at home. It seems like the Chiefs just always beat the Bills. I'm not going to change it now, right?
And then moving over to our nightcap on Sunday, we got the Cowboys going on the road to face the only undefeated team in the league, the Eagles. And give me Cooper Rush and the boys. I think this team just has something brewing here. The Cowboys, the Eagles, they've started to come back down to earth these last few weeks after them escaping in Arizona. But it is at home. The Eagles have played better at home this year. But that doesn't matter. This is a divisional game, and divisional games get crazy, especially in that, you know, NFC East we've seen in previous years. It's been a crapshoot, you know, a battle of 9-9 or 9-8 and, yep, you know, kind of everywhere right around 500. But this year it's a different story, but I still think it's going to be battles like that. And I think, you know, these games are going to matter late in the year, record-wise, and for to see who wins division. And in the long run, I like the Cowboys. You know, Dak's return is probably next week against the Lions. But that doesn't matter. You know, as I said, Cooper Rush, I think this will be his best game yet. And the ground game will really get involved here. But they're going to stifle the Eagles at home.
That's quite a prediction. I think that'll be interesting. This is going to be a really interesting game. And, you know, these games are going to matter coming late in the season. I'm going to take the Eagles, though, 5-0, looking to be 6-0. Kind of really crazy. I wasn't expecting the Eagles going to be this good as either. But that run game and that defense have looked really, really impressive. Cowboys defense has looked like one of the best defenses in the league with a couple of superstars. And Cooper Rush has been balling as well. I think this is going to be a really good game. I'm going to take the Eagles by a shootout, probably by like a field goal. I'm going to say like 24 to 21.
And then Monday night, we got somehow, some way the Broncos playing in another primetime game versus the Chargers, who have kind of struggled here. But I think that's more to impart to not having Keenan Allen. They're all reliable, has not been out there. This week, he's turning upward like he will play, but I think they're taking it just super precautionary with him because they have other weapons, and especially Gerald Everett this year has really stepped out and had his best career, you know, stats through week 5. And I think it continues here. Even when Allen gets back, he's a big target across the middle of the field. And Eckler, you know, has been balling out these last 2 weeks, and I expect him to keep hot. And if you want to take a bet, I'm loving that 4.5 against the Broncos for the Chargers. I just think that this offense is ready to break out and have one of their games, because we saw them put up 30 piece against the Browns, and that's more like these Chargers scoring a lot of points, winning close games. But I don't think it's going to be a close game. I think Chargers win this one probably 34-13.
Yeah, I can see a blowout happen as well. Broncos just have not looked good on offense. Seems that they can't score a touchdown anymore. So it's not a good recipe when you're going against one of the best offenses in the league. Especially if Keenan Allen plays, Chargers should win it big, no doubt in my mind.
And that's going to be it for our video today. Make sure you guys hit that subscribe button. Gets to 200. Like I said, we'll be doing that autograph item giveaway. But until the next time, the Bench Buddies are out. She never called back.